Hi, and welcome to the video on interview questions and answers for market research analysts from careerright.com. One of the basic requirements for any business to grow is understand the needs and preferences of its customers and the trends going on in the market. And it is the process of market research that helps them get all the information required for this. So you can understand how important is the role of market research analyst in any business. In this video, we are going to discuss some important conceptual and practical questions that are often asked in the interview for this position. Let's start and stay connected till the end. And here comes your first question. What is market research? Well, this is quite a basic question, but something that the interviewer can ask to begin the interview. To answer this question, you can say, market research is the process of gathering important information, drawing some inferences out of it, and summarizing it in the form of easy to understand reports to reach a conclusion. One of the very important qualities of good professionals is that they're aware of why they are doing what they are doing. And since they know the impact their work would have on the whole business, they are always more effective. Now, to understand how well aware are you of the impact of your work in this profile, the interviewer might ask you their next question. And it could be, why do we do market research? To answer this question, you can say, the ultimate aim of market research is to improve the business performance. It helps a business by understanding its consumers' needs and wants, and ultimately helps in identifying the opportunities for new and upcoming products. It also helps in preparing market strategies. Then a good market research also helps you keep closer to your competition. It helps you in knowing their products, strategies, status in the market, etc. And once you know all these things, you can deal with them better. Market research also helps you reduce the risk in business by anticipating the new trends. Then market research focuses on identifying the correct audience for your product, which helps you to choose the right medium of advertisement. Also, the businesses which spend time and efforts on market research are able to identify the problems at a nascent stage and solve them quickly. And all this helps in improving the sales and revenue. Okay, coming on to the next question. What are the different types of market research? Now, this looks like an easy question, but is an important one because it tests your basic knowledge about the subject. To answer this question, you can say, the two types of market research that we conduct are primary research and secondary research. The research done to get first-hand information about a topic is called as primary research. It is also known as fresh data and is done by the researcher himself. In this case, the data is raw, which makes it a time-consuming process to draw inferences from it. This is a comparatively costlier way of conducting the research. Now, the secondary research uses information from the research conducted by other people. The required information is already published in the public domain and is available directly for consumption. Since the data is already available here, this research doesn't take a long time. All that you have to do is collate, analyze, and interpret the data. It is the faster and cheaper out of the two ways. Now, an effective professional is the one who knows his tools the best. With their next question, the interviewer may try to judge just this. And their question in your case could be, what are the different research tools used for primary research? To answer this question, you can say, though expensive and time-consuming, primary research is accurate. It is mostly done when it is the only way to get the information, or the researcher doesn't rely on the available data. The different tools used to conduct this research are surveys, questionnaire, focus groups, interviews, simple observation, etc. Okay, now there are a lot of candidates who often get confused between survey and questionnaire. If you are one of them, please pay attention. While the survey and questionnaire may look similar, they are actually different and can't be used interchangeably. To use the right word at the right place, you have to know what each of them does, and then you'll be much comfortable in using them correctly. While the purpose of a questionnaire is to collect data, a survey collects the data for statistical analysis, forecasting, and to study trends. Let's take an example. When a school collects the information about the medical history of a child at the time of admission, it is a questionnaire that you fill, and its purpose is to just collect the data about the child. But when a school collects the data to study anemia in primary school children of a particular area, it is a survey. So here, you may have a questionnaire on anemia to conduct a survey. Okay, now once you have talked about the tools for primary research, the interviewer may try to judge your understanding about secondary research as well. And they may ask you, what are the sources of information for secondary research? To answer this question, you can say, secondary research is mostly conducted to understand market trends or to understand if there have been any changes in the preferences of the people. This information is something that has been collected and analyzed by someone else. So some of the sources of data for secondary research can be official publications by central and local government, reports submitted by research scholars, economists, research and educational institutions, etc. Then newspaper and periodicals can be a good source of information, trade journals specific to your industry, websites, unpublished data maintained by private firms, business enterprises, research workers, etc. can also be put to use. So these are some of the major sources of information for secondary research. Moving on to the next question. What are the common mistakes you should avoid while preparing your survey questions? A well-written survey questionnaire will enable the respondents to answer the questions correctly without getting confused. So the type of questions a researcher must avoid in his survey are, number one, the leading questions. A leading question includes non-neutral words because it takes the reader to one side of the argument. For example, a question like, do you have a problem with your boss? Indicates the prospect of having some problem. Instead, you can ask, how is your relationship with your boss? The second type of questions to avoid are loaded questions. Loaded questions contain an assumption within themselves. These questions force the respondents into an answer that doesn't reflect their true opinion or situation. For example, a question like, why is the sky blue? Is a loaded question. Instead, you can ask, what is the color of the sky and why is it so? The third type of questions that we have got on our list are double-barreled questions. This is a common mistake in almost every survey. Here the surveyor asks two questions in one. For example, is this box interesting and useful? Instead of asking this, you may ask, is this box interesting? And is this box useful? In two separate questions. The next type of questions to avoid are confusing and complicated questions. And this has got a lot to do with the language of your questions. The language you use in your questions should be clear, concise, and absolutely uncomplicated. If there are any difficult terms, explain them. Do not confuse the respondents in any way. For example, rather than asking, what is the state of cleanliness in your kitchen? You may ask, how clean is your kitchen? Keep it simple. The next two type of questions to avoid are negative questions, that is questions with no, not in them, and the questions irrelevant to the survey. Moving on to question number 7. Name some popular and widely used statistical data analysis methods for market analysis. To answer this question, you can talk about some popular market analysis tools, for example, SWOT analysis, gap analysis, max diff analysis, trend analysis, conjoint analysis, etc. Here it is very important to know each of these methods in detail so that you can discuss them conveniently if the need arises. Moving on to the final question of this video. What are the key skills required to be a successful market research analyst? Well, the purpose of this question is to understand, number one, if you are aware of the skills required to succeed in this role, and number two, if you possess these skills yourself. So, to answer this question, you can say, some of the most important skills required to be a market research analyst are attention to detail and accuracy, good analytical ability, excellent knowledge of statistics, physical strength so that you can conduct the surveys, and ability to work under pressure, effective IT skills so that you can make good use of technology, ability and flexibility to learn things, good organizational skills, excellent communication skills, and research analysis can be a really lengthy process. So above all, a lot of patience to finish what you have already started. To be able to answer this question effectively, I always advise the candidates to read the job description very well, because the skills required may vary from business to business a bit. And then you also must have the examples ready to tell the interviewer that you do possess these skills and qualities. So just take some time, think over some examples from the past which you can quote during the interview. With this, we come to the end of this video. If you recently interviewed for a similar position, do let us know the questions that were asked to you by commenting in the box below. If you found this video useful, do give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. To stay updated with more such career-related topics, do subscribe to our channel. Thank you and see you in the next one.